Well, it's been over a week now. We're back in the log cabin. Let's take a little look at what we've been up to. Take a look at the hydrographics tank. I've pulled everything out, as you know. We're working on the tank to get it in the position where we can actually fill it up with water. Let's just show you how I've actually created this drip tray on the end of the tank. Let's have a look. Well, here's the tank, as you can see. I've pulled it out at the moment. I had to create a waste trap for the water to run away once the water's up to sort of level. The level's going to be about here, for example. And I could have put some sort of drip tray combination inside, but I didn't want to actually encroach on the size of the tank. So what I've actually done, I cut a very small slot there, and some people was commenting saying that I might lose integrity for the actual fiberglass strengthening because I've actually removed this lip sort of thing, you know, the top lip. But what I've actually done, I've put angle iron there, and it's not angle iron, it's aluminium, and as you can see, that has actually retained the rigidity of the tank because that was a bit floppy before, so that's reinforced the strength and put the strength back in. I've put this aluminium strip on, as you can see there, and on the other side of it, what I've actually done, I've got now this is guttering, but normal guttering wouldn't have done the job in my eyes. I wanted some sort of a deeper sort of thing than guttering. I actually found this, which is what they call deep guttering. Now standard guttering probably comes down to about sort of there. It's a lot more shallow, so this thing is a lot deeper. And what I've actually done, I've actually fixed it underneath, as you can see there, with the guttering brackets. I don't know if you can see that properly, and just along the lip there, so the water's going to basically come in here, run over into the gutter, and then it will go down this hole I've actually sort of cemented in place there, which is basically a waste trap, and that will go down to a waste pipe. Down at the bottom of the tank there, as you can see, I've just put in a normal tank connector with a 22mm, so I've got the facility there to drain the tank down. And that will latch on to that drain pipe, which you can see I've put in the corner there. And what I'm also going to do, rather than put this pipe in solid into the actual waste, I'm going to just fix basically a hose connection with some flexible pipe and take that into the waste pipe down there with a T cut in there. So if I want to ever sort of disconnect this and basically blow it out or flush it out or whatever, I can actually just remove this hose and do that, so it won't be solidly wired. But as you can see, this is a lovely solid fix in there, and this deep guttering is providing enough. Now what I'm going to do, I've actually backfilled underneath there with silicone, but what I could do, if there is a problem with leakage, I don't think there will be, I can automatically just bend this lip down so that provides a drip coming into the actual tray as well. But it should be okay because it's well sealed under there. But yeah, that's the way I've got over that problem. And we've still retained the rigidity of the tank by putting an angle bracket along there. And as you can see there, that's turned out quite nice actually, so I'm well pleased with that. The other end, which is up there, I've got this copper pipe, which I will be attaching via some pipe clips connected to here. As you can see, what I've done, I've put the fill point in the middle because I wanted the water to disperse evenly along the length of the... I'm going to drill small holes along here, you see. And that should disperse the water evenly both sides. So that will be like that basically. And I'm toying with the idea of just coming here and along the top here with just a piece of flexible pipe going to a valve. So that'll be the cold water, the hot water feed coming in and shooting across the top of the actual water tank. And then I'll also have another valve here with sort of a spout going in so I can crack up, and that will be the fill valve. So that's what I'm probably going to do there. As far as the plumbing is concerned, I was going to have the hot boiler feed coming into it as well. Now I've bought with that idea because I've actually got hot water on tap. I'll show you that in a second. But what we've basically got in here is coming in from outside. We've got a cold water feed coming in from outside. That goes through this thing, which is basically a check valve and a pressure valve as well. And it's got to be connected in a certain way. So the cold feed comes in, and then here we have a tee up to this, which is a pressurisation vessel. As you can see, that's going to sit on there like that. And you need that on your cold supply after the check valve. In other words, there shouldn't be any valve in this line at all. And what the basically what the pressure vessel does, because it's what you call an unvented system, as the pressure builds up in there when the water heats up, the pressure needs somewhere to go because it's not vented, it's not open vented. So what you have, the water is allowed to expand via this pressurisation vessel here, which sits there. And in there, halfway up there, is a diaphragm, and the top part of it is air, and the bottom part of it is obviously the water in the system, basically. So as the water heats up and expands, this then, the diaphragm in there is able to lift up, and this is where you can actually balance the pressure of the actual system and without a fear of explosion. That is one safety device which you need to have on an unvented system, as well as the pressure system here, which is the pressure relief valve, which needs to be installed, as I've said to you before. And you've also got a pressure relief valve, as I said to you, on the top of this check valve here. Both of these will go down to an open, what they call a tun dish, which is that little thing there with a little hole in it, via a copper pipe, so that if that builds up pressure through not venting properly for whatever reason, and the pressure builds up too much, you'll get a dispersing of hot water straight down out through there, and you'll be able to see it. And if the mains pressure for some reason is too great, the check valve here will actually open and send the water down to there. So there's two basic safety features on the water supply to an unvented system, and you have to have them installed. So that is that. And the reason why I'm not going to have the coils actually fitted up, as I said to you in the initially, is, and this is what I was going to do, if I need to fill the tank up from cold, I don't really want to have to use this, because it takes more, about three or four of these to fill it up, and that'll take quite a while. So all I'll do, just across the way there, just outside, I've got my hot tub, which is constantly at 38 degrees or whatever. So all I need to do is to get a pump and pump from the hot tub straight into there, and that will probably take about 10 minutes with an external pump, and that will just fill the tank up, and then use this as a top up as what I was going to do anyway. So that's the reason why I'm not going to actually install the hot water supply to this. This will only ever be used as, this is double insulated as well. This is very good for heating up electrically, which I'm just going to use. And we'll just use the electricity at night via the night rate. So we'll be using the nighttime electricity costs, which is a lot lower, and that will be heating up the tank. And a good hot tank of water, this will probably last all day. Bearing in mind, you'll only be topping it up every now and again. So that is the system. So the final pipes are being run in now. We'll have a hot and a cold supply to the bath tap. I've got some mixer taps which are going on there. And as you can see, I've drilled the third hole on there, which is where the hot feed's gonna come from the top of the tank onto the top, which lays on the top of this, as I mentioned to you before. And that will be a valve, and that will send you your hot water skimming across the top of the water. But yeah, all in all, I'm very pleased with that, and it's turned out very well. Well, that's a little hot update on the hydrographics tank. We're just going to carry on now, plod along and do a few bits and pieces. We've got a lot of clearing up to do. It's been a bit of a mess in here because, you know, I've had a dodgy knee, and I'm just waiting the results from the x-ray at the moment. So I've got it bandaged up, but I'm not going to be doing a lot of kneeling and about. I've been off all week, so that's why you've had no videos all week anyway. So anyway, I'm just going to carry on now and do a little bit. Gary's outside having a bit of a tidy up, and I think he's listing some lawnmowers. Just going to have a look what Gary's doing. Right, so Gary's just having a little clear up around here, as you know, this little area here. So our cold feed's got to come through there. I don't know if you can see it over there. There's our cold feed on the other side of the wall there, which is just sticking out of the back of the log cabin there. So we've got to basically route that down, probably go underground here. And then here we'll box it in, and that will go into the house just there. There's a cupboard there where there's a boiler, so we've got a cold water supply there anyway. So that's what the plan is there. So Gary's just listing a few lawnmowers. These are going to be put on eBay shortly. He's kept all these ones, as you can see there. They're the ones he's going to possibly be working on, so that's not too bad. And over the back here, I've still got some old lawnmowers here, which I'll probably just list on as spares or repairs. I've got enough on the top deck there to actually work on, so yeah, they're going to go on eBay, I think. But we're trying to clear this area here, as you can see. Look, we've got all this rubbish here, basically, so
Yeah, it's getting there. It's just a matter of finding time, because I've not had the time to do this week because I've had a bad knee, so I've been doing virtually nothing. And this is where we want to obviously build on the another cabin here, which we'll build just for like the spraying area. So, you know, we're going to get some wood and do that, and probably pour a bit more cement down here to make a. This is a cement base here, which is reinforced anyway. So, but that ends to about there. So we'll just probably get some more cement down there with some support in it as well. So that's what we're looking at there. Right, here we go. Let's just have a quick look at the plumbing, what we've got here. So the cold water feed is in, as you can see, goes into the bottom of the tank. That's got to be for an overflow. Sorry, that's going to be for a drain off cop there, that bit there. So that's just going to go down there. So we haven't put that one in yet. These are the link ups from the safety valves on both sides there. They go down to that tun dish, as you can see there. So that if this lets by, it goes down and you get a visual indication in there. Just like if this one lets by, you'll get a visual indication in there. You would know which one would be letting by because they both go at the same tun dish. Because if this one lets by, it will be hot water coming through there, and you'll no doubt see some steam there. Or if this one is a problem, this will be cold water, and you'll have cold water coming through there. So that's how you're going to be able to determine which safety valve is going to be operated. That's the pressure vessel up there. It's still got to be strapped back there. Just coming around here, as you can see, we just put things back in place at the moment. We've got the hot and cold feeds running down here, but they've not been terminated yet. But we thought we'd just put the water into the tank. We're just going to see if we've got any leaks on any of these things. This is cold water, by the way, so that waste pipe's still got to be just connected up there, which isn't a problem. And as you can see, our nice drainage tray sits there lovely.
So I think it's time for a tea break. What are you ready?
I've got a phone call.
He's got a phone call.
You alright?
Someone wants a tank dipping. So there's our little overflow down there. Be interesting to see how long this takes to fill up, Gary.
You're going to be out here all night, I think.
Well, I don't know. We've got about 2 inches at the moment, so it's...
So what we don't want to see is any bleeding water patches on the floor from them big fiberglass... Where? He's having me on, there's no patches. We wanted water in it as well, because I've got to fit that spray bar on this side, as you know. And depending on how level the floor is, will depend on how high that goes with relations to our jet's going to go in. So,
well, we're going to be out here for a while, so we'll just come back to you again when the water's up to level. Right, we're getting there. I just thought I'd connect up this waste pipe. I've changed my mind. We found this bloody pipe I had, look. We've just run that along. I was going to tee into that main copper pipe down there, as you know, but I decided against that in case some of this film got stuck in the pipe. And being flexible, I've just got to pull that in from outside and I can blow it out. So there you go. Look, I just found this bit of pipe inside. Look, absolutely lovely job. Jubilee clip on there. And that's my waste pipe, as you can see there. Absolutely fantastic.
How lucky were we there?
Very lucky.
Hey, I love it when a plan comes together like that. It's been going for about 15 minutes now, so we're getting there. As you can see, look, we're up to well past the drain off cop down there. The patch on the floor down the bottom there, there's 2 patches there which appear to be fine. So we're probably about a third of the way there, I would say. But as you say, I had to get that waste connected up because we want the water to come up to the level here and then see it running through and then down the waste pipe and outside.
Nice cold at the moment. I've got a little temperature probe, by the way, which will just sit on the edge here somewhere. It's only a little battery operated thing, but it'll do the job. But so we just wanted to get some water in here just to make sure that our level was okay for when I fit the actual spray bar there. So that's what we're doing now. I'm going to start off with small holes in this, probably not too sure yet, but I don't want to go too big because we'll lose pressure. So if I start off with, like, I don't know, an eighth or something like that, do a row 3 there and 3 there maybe, so we've got 6 8 holes, and then see what that does. And I mean, if I do over drill these, I can always make another one of these up anyway, so it's not a problem. But I'll start off with smaller holes first, as opposed to like a quarter holes. I think they'd be too big. And as long as it just pushes the crap along the surface and into that trough, that's all that we need. So yeah, that's what we're going to be doing with that. We've had the whole fire, we're 1/2 hour into filling it up. Our waste tank connector down here
Let's show you.
That thing down there, between the tank and the tank fitting itself, it is basically leaking. So we've done nothing else. We've got to actually, as you can see there, I thought it might look a bit dodgy because it didn't sort of pull up square. But we're just going to have to drain the water out, take that off, and then we're going to have to silicone that in as well. So it's a little bit of a setback, and what it basically means is that we won't be filling it up on camera tonight. So you'll probably see that up to level tomorrow morning, because we've got to let the silicone go off overnight. So anyway, we'll end the video here, and I hope you enjoyed this little one anyway, just so that you can see we've made progress anyway. So anyway, see you again in the next video. Hope you enjoyed this. Bye for now.